So it's really hard to photograph native fish because, one, there aren't that many of them around these days. It's not often that people come out here and see giant kokopu in our stream. So our job's to really try and capture them and show people what's out there. For them to fall in love with, of course, hopefully. A lot of wildlife photography is just sitting and watching. The more you know about the animals, the better your success. So one photograph that I put a lot of effort into was photographing whitebait, which are the juvenile form of the giant kokopu and others, in the wild. And it was about a 3-day effort to get those images, hoping these little fish would come close enough to the camera and then they would see themselves reflected in the lens and scurry off, and I'd wait another 20 minutes and they'd come back. And so it was a great challenge and a great photograph.
So the trick is to use a wide angle, very wide lens, because I really want to catch the environment that the fish is in just as much as the fish itself.
And the idea is, as we go into dark, I'll be using underwater flash as well as overwater flash to balance out the environment as well as the fish. It's also a very nice time to sit there being present and being able to watch a native species, so I've got absolutely no complaints here at all. Beautiful time actually. So this will probably be the first of many visits, because one thing I've learned about photography is it's not until you understand the behaviour of individuals and animals and environment, you start noticing things, that you get the better shot. So this will probably be the first of numerous trips trying different conditions and different locations around here. And we'll just give it a quick test here. So yeah, it's going to work. It's just a matter of time now, patience.